Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding revisiting a passage from India written by KC Singh. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies, mains examination paper 2 and paper 3. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the diaspora and how India should be effectively utilizing this diaspora for its own benefits. So in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand two important things. First of all, we need to understand the importance of diaspora. And secondly, we need to understand the changes taking place in strengthening and engaging diaspora. First of all, let us understand what is meant by diaspora. Diaspora means that the people of Indian origin who have moved out of India and they're working in other countries. Diaspora means the people who have links, roots in India and they're working in other countries. Now this diaspora can play multiple roles, and these multiple roles can help India to revitalize its economy. It can help India to revitalize its diplomacy. It can help India to revitalize and strengthen India's position with respect to issues like WTO and irritants like in the India-Pakistan relationship and irritants in India-China relationship. So diaspora holds a lot of potential. Diaspora yearly sends in India the remittances up to the tune of around $70 billion. Now this is a huge amount, keeping India's dependency on the import bill with respect to energy resources. This is a huge amount, keeping in consideration how India is dependent with respect to the import of the machinery, with respect to a higher current account deficit that generally remains. Of late it has been less because of the decline in the oil prices. But the remittances sent by the diaspora has played a role of a cushion. They have played a role of a buffer. They have given strength to the Indian economy. They have rejuvenated Indian economy in the bad phases that Indian economy had turned into certain times. Of late, what we are witnessing is the changes in the dynamics of diaspora. Now, what kind of changes I am talking about? Changes, the first important change that the diaspora has begun to feel the heat of fundamentalism in their respective nations. The total number of diaspora, Indian diaspora, it turns out to be 31 million, around 3 crore se upar ki abadi diaspora ki hai. The first dynamics and the change that the diaspora is witnessing is the wave of fundamentalism, is the wave of nationalism and jingoism taking place in the respective countries wherever the Indian diaspora is settled. We have two big examples for this. The first example is the example of United States of America. The United States of America is trying to promote anti-immigration policies. United States of America is feeling that it is the immigrants who are taking away the jobs from the citizens of America. So America, first of all, wants to protect Americans, and it's only then it is ready to offer the jobs to the outsiders. Same thing is also happening, taking or unfolding in the Middle East countries, where the wave of urbanization is taking place. It's the urbs who wants to have access to all the jobs existing in the urban countries. Now this has become more intense after the fall in the oil prices. After the fall in the oil prices, the Indian diaspora living in the Middle East countries is passing through a very tough time. Now it is passing through, why it is passing through a tough time? It is passing through a tough time because generally Indian diaspora is less skilled. And this is one of the reasons that in the recent Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, that is the 14th Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, government of India has decided to launch a new policy in the form of Pravasi Kaushal Vikas. Now this is the new policy that the government is coming out with. This government will focus on the skills that should be provided to the Pravasi Bhartiyas, to the diaspora that is living outside India, in order to provide them skills. So changes taking place. See, this diaspora can play a very substantive role in the diplomatic sphere. We have an example of Israel, whereby the Jews population has played a role in guiding America's policy towards Israel. Now, why Israelis have got so much of the support of the United States of America? It is purely because of the Jews population living in the United States of America. In the corridors of power in America, there are many Jews people holding higher echelons and higher positions. It is from their hold of these positions, they can actually exert a lot of weight of how America should be acting towards Israel. Now this similar thing can also happen in case of India. It should be unfolding in case of India. 31 million of a diaspora is not a small population. It's a huge diaspora base. Now what more India should be doing for the diaspora? Easy facilities for visas should be offered to the diaspora. Diasporas should be provided opportunities to invest in India. And this has become all more important keeping into consideration how outflow of FDA is taking place from India. 2016 was a year when India has seen a negative growth rate in its FDI. 2016 was also a year when maximum outflow of FDI has taken place from India. Now, such kind of economic issues can really cause fracturing in the economic indices for India. And in order to improve economic indices, we really need the support of this diaspora. The one figure is very important, the remittance figure of 70 billion. This is not a small amount, this is a very big amount. This is an amount that is really deciding how the Indian economy should be getting churned up. So this was all for the editorial decode. Now the question that can be asked, critically analyze the importance of diaspora to the India's diplomacy. Now the another question could be like, critically analyze how India should be engaging diaspora for its own benefits. So this was all for the class. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.